chosen one with whom I am pleased, upon whom I have put my spirit. He shall bring forth justice to the nations, not crying out, not shouting, not making his voice heard in the street. A bruised reed he shall not break, and a smoldering wick he shall not quench, until he establishes justice on the earth. The coastlands will wait for his teaching. I, the Lord, have called you for the victory of justice. I have grasped you by the hand. I formed you and set you as a covenant of the people, a light to the nations, to open the eyes of the blind, to bring out prisoners from confinement, and from the dungeon those who live in darkness. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
filled
with expectation.
And all were asking in their hearts whether John might be the Christ. John answered them all, saying, I am baptizing you with water, but one mightier than I is coming. I am not worthy to loosen the thongs of his sandals. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire. And for all the people had been baptized, Jesus also had been baptized and was praying. Heaven was opened, and the Holy Spirit descended upon him in bodily form, like a dove. And the voice came from heaven, You are my beloved Son. With you,
some of you may have heard me say this quite a bit, which is a passing over the years, but global, who are the seminarians of global? Do you remember Bishop Maloney? How too young to remember him? There used to be an auxiliary bishop of Louisville, Charles Maloney. Bishop Maloney was auxiliary for three different archbishops, but never left Archbishop Louisville. Supposedly, he was at the Second Vatican Council, and each session they would put two bishops together, and they knew put two different worlds kind of bishops together. His first roommate in the first session was a guy named Karol Wojtyla from Poland, later John Paul II. The late auxiliary bishop of Louisville, Charles Maloney, often commented that the most important day of his life was the day of his baptism. Many would be surprised that he did not consider or say his day of ordination as a priest or as a bishop. But he was quick to remind people that baptism is the sacrament of salvation. St. Augustine of Hippo was known to have commented, I am a Christian for my sake and a bishop for the sake of others. Of all the sacraments, baptism is the most essential. Without it, no other sacrament can be validly celebrated. It is one of three sacraments, along with confirmation and holy orders, that leaves an indelible mark on our souls, meaning its lasting effect, that grace is always with us. Even on death row, where we may be, no matter how wonderful or how horrible life we live, that grace is there, whether we make use of it or not, take it for granted, is one thing, but it's always present. No power on earth can take it away from us. Of course, as the second person of the Holy Trinity, Jesus did not need baptism for salvation. He did not seek baptism as a means of becoming holy, but to make the waters of baptism holy for others, for us. As John the Baptist prophesied, beyond mere water, Christ was baptized with the Holy Spirit and fire. At the heart of baptism is the universal call to holiness and mission. And if we're to live out this universal call, we obviously need that fire of the Spirit to spur us on, to empower us, to invigorate us in this mission. This universal call includes every member of the body of Christ, the church, not merely clergy and religious. The task of ordained ministers is to instruct and encourage those entrusted to our pastoral care in their respective embrace of this universal call. The members of the board here are here because of that universal call. It is the reason for which Jesus came into the world. It was the reason he allowed himself to be baptized. Some might recall the story from a couple of years ago about a priest, I believe in the Archdiocese of Detroit, who discovered he had never been baptized. Remember this story? He learned this after having served 3 years as a priest, that he was never validly baptized. They had to go back and baptize him, confirm him, ordained him. Of course, especially pertaining to weddings, this also impacted the sacramental celebrations he had performed as a priest prior to this discovery. In a sense, there was a domino effect of his sacramental life on the sacramental life of others. So it is with each one of us. how we live out our baptismal call to holiness and mission. There's a domino effect that happens in our lives, in the lives of our families, our parishes, in the lives of the world. Like John the Baptist, we must be clear about who we are and who we are not. None of us is the Christ, the Messiah. We run into a lot of people that think they are, but none of us is the Christ, the Messiah. Like John the Baptist, we are not worthy to loosen the thongs and sandals. If we authentically live out our baptism, we point not to ourselves, but we point others to Jesus Christ. We have to be like the moon lying the sun, the light of the sun shining through us. We are not the sun. We must be like the moon. Through Christ's inner witness, we are conduits of divine grace and mercy in the faith lives. As those of you here in the seminary formation education continue your journey, discerning the call to ordain priesthood, may you never take for granted the ways in which God is already at work in your lives through the sacrament of grace of baptism and confirmation and living out this call to holiness and mission. May you remember those you serve are called to that same holiness and mission, and oftentimes humble us by their holiness and their embrace of seem more than ourselves at times. May we respect this universal call in each and every baptized member of the church. It is the reason for which Jesus came into the world. It was the reason he allowed himself to be baptized. As beloved sons and daughters, as beloved children of God and the church, we have each been instilled with the fire of the Holy Spirit, nourished and sustained by this spirit. Our witness gives voice to the living Word of God, Jesus Christ, carrying forth his mission of transforming the world and inspiring hope for those who struggle in faith. May we never take for granted the difference we make. Better yet, may we never take for granted the grace of God at work in and through our lives and in the lives of others, as well as the grace at work and their witness to us. And it all begins.
Graciously grant them relief. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For ourselves and
those spoken and those who care in our hearts. May we seek always to glorify you by the grace you pour out upon us through the sacrament, especially the baptism and confirmation in the Eucharist, that we may continue to carry forth the good news of salvation, the good news of your Son, Jesus Christ, through our words and our deeds. In his name we pray now and forever.
Amen.
Thank you.
God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and of all his holy church.
Accept, O Lord, the offerings we have brought to honor the revealing of your beloved Son, so that the oblation of your faith may be transformed into the sacrifice of him, who will, in his compassion, wash away the sins of the world, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which we poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Save us, Savior, Lord of the world, through thy cross and presence.
wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven. And as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognize in the sacrificial victim, whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we, who are nourished by his body and blood, and filled with your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles, and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, under his constant intercession in your presence, we were alive by the favor of God. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your beautiful church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, me, your unworthy servant, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, in whom you bestow upon the world all that is good. Through heaven with heaven and now, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
get a shirt at the top if you're in your t-shirts underneath or facet. It's understandable. But to get a shirt and tie so that you can stand on the step with the other guys and sing the Saul thing. I want you to go there before you come down for donuts. When you come down for donuts, you may have two, you go through the line, and then you can go back later. Okay? If you are getting coffee, please put that in the kitchen and allow the coffee in the dining hall to be for our guests. We'll be down there when the time comes. I know that the crew will see after the Saul Day, Regina. They're going to take some time to interview Fedora, but they may transition to do that in the chapel or somewhere else. So we'll let them fall up where that filming takes place.
Joe, thank you very, very much. Great for your leadership. This is the shortest job I have been to anywhere, so this is the best. Does this mean, however, that they're going to take about 10 minutes? Does that mean the board and I can go to the office while they're setting up?
Yeah.
All right. So we get the hit on that.
Yeah.
Just want to make sure I understood everything.
That's
all. I like
the
plan.
I do too.
Thank you all. I hope you have a great semester. It's time you have a great retreat. It's a good way to start the year, and it's a good year. It's a good semester. Be assured of my continued prayers for you. Please pray for me and whoever put up with me every day. So, I really appreciate it. Let's ask the Lord's blessing. The Lord.